Hello, friends. I was filming my video, and then we had a drone in our yard, and my kids and I had to chase it away. Do you have drones in your area? We have a lot of them here because there are a lot of realtors, and they take them down to the beach all the time, and I am just anti-drone. I'm just not gonna lie right now, okay? Anyway. Let's move on from that. If I'm looking extra dewy, that's why. So, friends, I'm gonna change the name of my YouTube and Instagram. And that is because I just want to. And I don't really have any complex reason other than I don't really think that "And the Color Green" ever really made sense to anyone but me. It's a fragment of a song lyric. And so yeah, now I'm changing it to my childhood nickname, which is even less marketable. But have I ever really done anything to make this channel or my Instagram or myself more marketable? No. Okay, so if you have been following along on Green Beauty Theory, if you have been following along in the media, if you are actively looking for resources of ways to educate yourself to help our society and anti-racism, my friend Keisha Adinkra, she has her own YouTube and Instagram account. She has put together a reading list for us. She is a beautiful Black woman, and I feel very thankful that she took the time and energy to try to share things that she felt may expand our minds. So I'm gonna link that below, and I'm gonna tell you it's 6 books. So the first one I'm gonna be starting with personally is by Angela Davis. It's called Freedom is a Constant Struggle. It sounds really interesting, and it's around the concept and the struggle related to freedom. So that's where I'll be starting, and like I said, I'm gonna link it below. Check it out if you have the time. I also, on Green Beauty Theory, I've started a community highlight reel. So as of today, I have about 25 Black women and I think one man of people who put out clean beauty content. So go check that out if you're interested in finding and connecting to more Black community members. So I wanted to update you on a couple things. I've made some purchases and I've gotten some Beauty Heroes stuff recently. So the first thing I picked up was this Axiology Lip to Lid Balmies. And it is the of the world. I forget what it's called. Of the earth, maybe. It's got 3 sort of earthy colors to it. And one is this sort of champagne color. They are not gonna swatch well in this lighting. And to be honest, I don't love them very much. It's interesting because they feel firmer and less pigmented than their lipsticks, which is weird. So they were $36 for 3, and they're kind of tiny. They're a no-waste situation, and they feel like they have a lot of wax in them. They haven't gotten soft, even though it's been quite warm here, so that might be why they feel a little bit unworkable. And so, actually the pigment looks pretty nice, actually, when you look at it closer. So I don't know, I'm still playing with them. I guess I thought they would be more buttery. And I thought, I don't know what I thought. Except that when I've used them on my eyes as sort of like a tint, they don't have really any staying power. So I don't know, guys, I don't know. I'm not a makeup expert. But so far, I don't know that I would spend the money on this. More to come in the future. So now where to go next? Let me tell you about See New Subscription Box. Have you heard of it? It's kind of an awkward name. Friends, the box is $44. It ships every other month. And this past month, they had Kahina Giving Beauty in there, and you got 5 full-sized products, and it included shipping. Mic drop, all right? So for $44, I got a full-sized facial lotion, which is amazing because I've been using it as a cream cleanser. It's super lightweight, it's based with that argan oil, that's kind of their signature ingredient, and I have been loving it for that. It came with their toning mist, which is Bulgarian rose water. It's just light, it feels semi-hydrating, it's beautiful, it's therapeutic feeling. Then you got their antioxidant mask, which feels very creamy and luxurious. And their moisture mask, which I just have been using as a night cream whenever I kind of feel like changing it up from my Wellita. And then it also came with a full size or 30 mLs of their argan oil. Okay, so let me give you a quick update on the skincare routine I've been doing. Pretty consistently on a daily basis, I will cleanse with a facial toner. I'll mist with the facial mist. I've been using the Little Fox Couture Haute C, the Bright Serum Concentrate. It has 15% oil-soluble vitamin C, vitamin E, and ferulic acid. It's got this very lightweight, creamy texture. It has a semi-orange scent to it. You see, I feel about this already how I felt about the Blue Alchemy Botanic Retinol. Like, I don't even want to swatch it because I want to conserve it. It's got the most gorgeous, luscious, creamy, hydrating, essence-y type serum texture to it. So I've been doing these two. I'll top it with just a light layer of this. I could almost get away not using this, and then I'll put on my Sun Integrity Impeccable Skin. That's my AM routine, and I have been I've been using this now for 3 weeks, twice a day, and I've been having great skin. It's been feeling super hydrated. Now, granted, it's been extremely warm here, so my skin is holding a lot of hydration. Been drinking a lot of water, trying to cut back on the coffee, so I've been having good skin days. But I think this thing is really helping. So at night, I'm using my own homemade oil cleanser, which I remove with a cloth. I'll cleanse again with this, then I'll use this, and then I'll use this. I have just been having great skin. Like, I highly recommend, if you're interested in picking up this box for this vitamin C product, I'm really enjoying it. I really feel like the box, the Beauty Heroes box this month, is a great value. Now, there's the Dewy Bean Dream Soothing Bedtime Mask that also comes. They're both two full-size products this month, and I believe they're both being launched with Beauty Heroes. And if you're not familiar with Beauty Heroes, I'll link it below. It's a subscription box. I'm a Beauty Heroes ambassador. They send me these products to try, which is why I've already been testing this product. I got it May 15th. I've already been testing it consistently 2 times a day since then. And I just feel like the tone of my skin has just really improved. So anyway, this is a mixture of acids. It doesn't have bakuchiol, it has moth bean extract, which kind of acts very similarly to bakuchiol. It's the same sort of mechanism where it's not a vitamin A product. It is a vitamin A alternative. So instead of using vitamin A for cellular turnover, there you are using plant extracts in the moth bean. More on this to come. It's a very strong product is what I'll say. And actually I believe like what's occurred is that I've used it incorrectly because I've layered it on very thick. And I don't think that's ideal. I think you should put a very thin layer on. So there's that. Okay, let me give you a quick update on my thoughts on the Ilia Limitless Lash Mascara. I have been really liking it. It has a lot of the same performance as the Honest Company mascara, but it just feels a lot easier to remove. And one of the things that's cool about the mascara is it has this little brush for separating your lashes. It's like a little comb on the end. So after you apply the mascara, you can kind of go through with the comb edge and separate your lashes. I don't know, I've just really been liking the formula, and I find that it hasn't irritated my eyes at all. So that's been really positive for me. The other thing is that Beauty Heroes sent over this deodorant, this zero waste deodorant by Cleo and Coco for us to try. It is a deodorant bar. It's been dipped in wax. It came in this cute bag, and then the outer packaging was this paper tube. So you do have quite a bit of packaging in the idea of zero waste at times. So I'll be trying this. They also sent over their charcoal deodorant, which is baking soda free. I have a sensitivity to baking soda. And so far I've found it's performing really well. I've tried it 3 times. Generally, these type of deodorants don't really work for me. I don't use them on a consistent basis. However, when I go to work, I find, which is when I have to go to the office, I find I do need something with arrowroot powder or baking soda powder for just those couple of days. Most of the time I don't need anything like that, but I find occasionally I need just a little bit of that sort of absorbent odor neutralizing stuff. I should do a deodorant video on all the ones I've tried of like over the last 5 years. Anyway, friends, I just wanted to come on and just make a pretty quick basic video and talk about some beauty products. I've been spending a lot of time this past week just with my nose buried in social media absorbing, and I just needed to take a break and relax a little bit. So how are you guys doing? I'm 3 videos behind on responding to comments, and I apologize. Till the end of June is gonna be pretty busy for me. And so after June though, I'm hoping my life is gonna calm down a little bit, and I'll be talking more about that coming up here. Have a great week, and I'll see you next week. Bye.